This is the 11th lecture of class 12 physics, and in this lecture we will discuss about the very important topic, that is Gauss theorem. And after this Gauss theorem we will discuss about the potential energy of electric dipole. But just before discuss this important topic Gauss theorem, another concept is also necessary to understanding about this Gauss theorem, that is Gaussian surface. Listen very carefully, what is the concept of Gaussian surface? Gaussian surface means imaginary surface. Suppose a charge is held at a point and we are imagining a sphere around the charge, then that imaginary sphere is defined as Gaussian surface, and with the help of this Gaussian surface we can find out the electric field very easily. Now see the condition of Gauss theorems. How the Gauss theorems derived? This is the Gaussian surface around a charge Q, and we are taking an imaginary this Gaussian surface in such a way that the radius is R, and we are taking a small amount of area, that is ds. This is the direction of vector field intensity at this point, and this is the direction of area vector, and radius position vector also directed towards O to P. This is O point. This is the Gaussian surface. And the Gaussian surface that is spherical in shape. The concept of Gauss theorem, the total flux linked with a closed surface. The total flux linked with a closed surface is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed by the surface. Total charge enclosed by the surface. It means phi e, that is phi e is equal to q upon epsilon not. We have to prove that this concept by using this diagram. Now calculating the electric field intensity, first of all by simple concept, definition of electric field intensity, by definition of electric field intensity, E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square. With the help of this value of intensity we can calculate the flux linked with small amount of area ds, that is the small value of flux. So small amount of flux, small amount of flux linked with ds, that is d phi e is equal to e ds. Here vector e and vector ds both are in the same direction, so angle between both, that is 0 degree. So e ds cos 0 degree, and cos 0 value means what? 1. So e ds, with the help of this value of a small flux we can calculate the total flux linked with this charge and passes through that enclosed surface. So total flux phi e is equal to integration of a closed surface, that is e ds, and the e ds means what? That is the value of d phi e. So the value of e, that is what? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught
upon r square and a ds, because e ds is equal to only e ds. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square closed surface ds. And the integration over closed surface ds, that is what? The surface area, either total surface area or curved surface area, both value same case of sphere, that is equal to what? 4 pi r square. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square into 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square, 4 pi r square cancel out. So q upon epsilon naught. Hence, phi e is equal to q upon epsilon naught. This is the proof of Gauss theorem. Very simple derivation. Only one concept you have to utilize here, that is the concept of flux. And the flux here, intensity and surface area. And intensity and surface area for small value surface area, small amount of flux obtained, and then calculating total flux means what? Integrating the small amount of flux. And now after this, the remaining concept of previous derivation, that is electric dipole, we are calculating just the potential energy of electric dipole. Very simple derivation. Potential energy of electric dipole, whenever potential energy calculated means what? Then there is a concept of work done in rotating the given dipole from theta 1 to theta 2. Potential energy of electric dipole. You know that tau is equal to what? P E sine theta. As we know, then by definition of work done, small amount of work done for small amount of rotation, that is GW is equal to what? Tau d theta. This is the concept of definition of work done is what? That is work is equal to force into displacement. So force here, turning effect of force and displacement, angular displacement. So total work done W is equal to what? Integration from theta 1 to theta 2, that is dW, and the value of dW, that is tau d theta. The value of tau, that is from above equation, PE sine theta, PE sine theta, this is the total work done, and P constant term here, so taken out, integration of sine theta, theta 1 to theta 2, d theta, and integration of sine theta means what? Cos theta with negative sign. Integration limit here, theta 1 to theta 2. Integration of sine theta d theta equal to what? Minus cos theta. And then we have to put first upper limit and then lower limit. So minus taken out firstly, minus PE cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. This is the work done. And work done, when we put the value of theta 1, that is 90 degree, and theta 2 is equal to theta, then minus PE cos theta. Here using theta 1 is equal to 90 degree and theta 2 is equal to theta. In vector form, we can write this equation in vector form. This is the work done, and this work done, whenever done by the electric field, then this work done is stored in the form of potential energy. So U is equal to W is equal to minus PE cos theta. In vector form, U is equal to what? Minus vector P dot vector E. Very simple concept. When this concept is known, and the concept of work done you are knowing from class 9, 10th and 11th concept, then small amount of work done for small displacement, and at last calculating total amount of work done, we are integrating from theta 1 to theta 2, and finally we got the result PE cos theta with negative sign in vector form. Cos component means what? Always a dot product of two vectors. That's all for today. Thank you.